Something has changed within me. Something is not the same. I'm through with playing by the rules of someone else's game.
Too late for second guessing. Too late to go back to sleep.
It's time to trust my instincts. Close my eyes.
Someone says they're so. Some things I cannot change, but till I try, I'll never know. Too long I've been afraid of losing love. I guess I've lost.
Well, if that's love, it comes at much too high a cost.
Shoshana Bean, and welcome to our third annual and first virtual concert fundraiser for the performing arts at my alma mater, Beaverton High School. Go Beavs! Last month, we made an impassioned decision to postpone our originally scheduled concert date. We felt it was imperative to step aside as there were voices much more important than ours that needed to be heard. Tonight, we gather again, not because the need to listen deeply and keep fighting for social justice isn't still there, but because we have the power to add something necessary and important to the conversation, music. Music has always had the power to heal. It can implore us to listen, to learn. It can help us grieve. It can help us feel empathy and compassion. And most importantly, music can stir our souls into action. When it became clear that we were not going to be able to have our live and in-person concert this year, it was important to me that these students were not robbed of the entire experience. So we found a way to pivot and make it happen virtually. Leading up to the concert, I worked with these kids one-on-one via Skype or FaceTime or Zoom. I have heard their stories, I have heard their fears, and I have felt their pain. For a lot of them, the arts are the only places where they feel seen and heard, connected, empowered, and special. They are the only places where they can truly express themselves. They deserve to continue to have a place where they feel safe. They deserve to have their voices heard. They deserve to build confidence and a sense of community. But sadly, the programs and departments that provide this type of environment are quickly disappearing at the hands of budget cuts. And that is why we are here tonight. There is a link that lives over there pinned in the comment section. There's a link that lives below in the description. Please consider giving whatever you are able to help us keep the arts alive and thriving in our public schools. I firmly believe that it is up to us to pick up the slack where the government and the districts are failing our children. And what I know about my artistic community is that we show up for one another. We take care of one another. So thank you for showing up tonight, and thank you in advance for whatever you are able to give. Enjoy the show.
Superboy and the Invisible Girl, son of steel and daughter of air. He's a hero, a lover, a prince. She's not there. Superboy and the Invisible Girl, everything a kid ought to be. He's immortal, forever alive. Then there's me. I wish I could fly. Here, take my Kleenex, wipe that lipstick away. Show me your face, clean as the morning. I know things were bad, but now they're okay. Suddenly Seymour is standing beside me. Don't need no makeup, don't have to pretend. Suddenly Seymour is here to provide you sweet understanding. Seymour's your friend.
Nobody ever treated me kindly. Daddy left early, Mama was poor. I'd meet a man and I'd follow him blindly. He'd snap his fingers, me I'd say sure. But suddenly Seymour, standing beside me, he don't give me orders.
I'm Ari Shapiro, and I'm one of the hosts of All Things Considered on NPR. I also sing with the Portland band Pink Martini sometimes, and I do a show with Alan Cumming, which is kind of a live stage cabaret. But most importantly, I am an alum of Beaverton High School and the theater program specifically. And what I really remember from the performing arts at Beaverton was what it taught me about dedication. I mean, we had 6 a.m. dance rehearsals, and then after school rehearsals and weekend work parties. I remember teams of parents sewing costumes, spending all day Saturday and Sunday painting and building sets. The sense of teamwork and camaraderie that came out of those projects, and the ability to use my voice, is something that I still use every day in my work today as an adult, and I'm grateful for it. Thanks, Beaverton.
I dreamed a dream in time gone by, when hope was high and life worth living. I dreamed that love would never die. I dreamed that God would be forgiving. Then I was young and not afraid, and dreams were made and used and wasted. There was no ransom to be paid, no song unsung, no wine untasted.
And I know
I'm Mark Shaman, composer, lyricist, and all-around fabulous person. When I was growing up in junior high school and the 1 year of high school I went to before I escaped to New York with my GED diploma, there were no musicals being performed in my schools. Luckily for me, there were two ladies in the community, Judy Cole and Monya Unger, who were both came from show business, who saw this need and created what they called the Scotch Plains Fanwood Summer Musical Theater Workshop, which was quite a mouthful. But if it wasn't for them and that summer program, my life would be completely different. I went and auditioned to play piano for The Sound of Music, of all shows, and that began everything for me. So I both am very grateful to those two ladies, and it only points out how important it is to have performing arts in the schools. I was lucky to have these two ladies. Maybe there are a lot of kids who are not that lucky. So please, let's keep performing arts in the schools where it belongs. Bye.
He's a very smart prince. He's a prince who prepares, knowing this time I'd run from him. He spread pitch on the stairs. I was caught unawares, and I thought, well, he cares. This is more than just malice. Better stop and take stock while you're standing here stuck on the steps of the palace. You think, what do you want? Make a decision. Why not stay and be caught? You think, well, it's a thought. What would be his response? But then what if he knew who you were, when you know that you're not what he thinks that he wants? But then what if you are? intuition. Although, how can you know who you are till you know what you want? What you don't, so then which do you pick? Where you're safe out of sight and yourself, but where everything's wrong. Where everything's right and you know that you'll never be alone. And whichever you pick, do it quick, cause you're starting to stick to the steps of the palace. It's your first big decision. The choice isn't easy to make. To arrive at a ball is exciting and all. It's fun to deceive and you know you can leave, but you have to be wary. There's a lot that's at stake, but you've stalled long enough, cause you're still standing stuck in the stuff on the steps.
Better run along home and avoid the collision. Even though they don't care, you'll be better off there, where there's nothing to choose, so there's nothing to lose. So you pry up your shoes.
I'm out of the blue, and without any your decision is, which is not to decide.
You'll just leave him a clue.
For example, a shoe.
And then see what he'll do.
Now it's he and not you who is stuck with the shoe.
In a stew.
In the goo.
And you've learned something too, something you never knew.
On the steps of the path.
To hurt you too deep, someone to sit in your chair and ruin your sleep. Someone to need you too much, someone to know you too well. Someone to pull you up short, to put you through hell. Someone you have to let in. Someone whose feelings you spare. Someone who, like it or not, will want you to share a little.
Being alive. Okay, kids, your Aunt Shoshana asked me to talk to you about why arts are important in school. So, this is a egg. Now, science will tell you that an egg is good for you. Biology will tell you why it's good for you. Mathematics will tell you how long to cook it and what temperature and measure all kinds of stuff like that. But only the arts can take this egg and turn it into a dinosaur or a souffle or something magical. The arts, facts live all over the place. But imagination is in the arts. A egg.
Being a geek is the loneliest thing in the world. I gotta tell you that by when you're a geek, it's the loneliest thing in the world. You're always wondering what everybody's laughing about and staring in at the world like you got locked out. Nothing is worse, it's a crime, it's a curse, it's the loneliest thing in the world. Being a geek is the sorriest state ever known. I know what I'm talking about. Being a geek doesn't go once you're gone or you're grown. It's a downward spiral, the loneliest thing in the world.
But when you're cool, when you're cool, you know you've got a shot. You can break the rules and you're allowed. You can sway the gang in any direction. In a bag, it's the loneliest thing in the world.
If you like the wrong movies, if you like the wrong bands, if you take the wrong classes, don't speak,
you're a geek.
If it's Saturday and night and you don't have any plans, 'cause you spent the past week learning Greek,
you're a geek.
If you're very well acquainted with the locker room toilet, 'cause your head's been shoved inside it, just shriek,
I'm a geek.
If you start to get excited, 'cause you're gonna throw a party, but the people you've invited all squeak,
geek.
You freak. You're not unique,
geek.
It's just the life of the geek.
But when you're cool, you can rally when the blues attack. Every problem just rolls off your back. You can handle every slip and slide without breaking your stride. When you're cool, you don't care when people disappear. Don't care.
difference between being fine at 13 and the loneliest thing.
I said the loneliest thing.
I know it's the loneliest thing in the world.
Tonight evolved from last year, which evolved from being an album release show for my fourth album, and evolved into a fundraiser for the arts, which included an Instagram contest where I was aiming to find one student to duet with me, which turned into, like, I don't know, 20 some. And then we had such a good time and it was such a success last year that I wanted to do it again. So this year has evolved into basically just a concert with me and a bunch of kids.
I am so excited, and Shoshana is so positive. It's really awesome for someone like Shoshana, who is so successful, to be able to come back to her hometown, because it kind of shows somebody, especially in our field, that you can make it and that it can happen.
Shoshana is amazing, and I've looked up to her forever, and I'm just really excited to get to share a stage with her.
It's really, really great and really humbling.
I feel like this year the benefit goes beyond necessarily just the funds that we're able to raise for the department. My mission has always been to also just continue to raise awareness about the fact that the budget cuts are just annihilating these programs and the importance of them, especially these days with, you know, I think these kids suffer with, like, a lot of anxiety and depression and issues with their sexuality and issues with their gender identity and a lot more bullying and just things that I don't remember that we were as verbal about when we were growing up. And I think that the arts not only provides them with a community that helps them feel less alone, helps them connect with people, has them having something to look forward to and a place of feeling like they belong, but also gives them an outlet to express all of the feelings. They have a lot of feelings. In putting this together tonight, I've just found that there's kind of a bigger mission at play than just raising money and awareness for the arts, that there's also just little hearts and little lives that need saving.
The performing arts to me are really a way to express myself.
It allows people to tell stories and express their voices that normally wouldn't be heard.
So the performing arts have always kind of been a place where I can just fully be myself.
Like, it's a way of expression that I really enjoy.
Well, I think that they provide an outlet for people to express themselves in a way that they otherwise wouldn't be able to do so.
And I feel like everyone needs something to give them that extra push, and that's just my extra push, just personally.
I'm the same 5-year-old inside that just wants to put on a new show and dress up and bring a bunch of people together and have fun.
So pure, so electric.
Good evening. I'm Felice Moskowitz, the very proud mother of Shoshana Bean. I have had the privilege of being an arts educator for over 35 years, and all of it in the public sector. To be able to witness the transformative power of art on young lives has been one of the greatest rewards. But I've seen tremendous changes from the beginning of my experience up to and beyond my retirement over a year ago. Whenever educational focus shifts or budgets are cut, the arts are usually the most negatively impacted. Regardless, I have been and will continue to be a strong advocate for their value and importance in public education. And for good reason. I have living proof of how the arts can impact a child's life, namely, my daughter. And now, so do you as you watch these students perform this evening. If time allowed, I could share so many stories of young people overcoming obstacles because they had a reason to get up in the morning and go to school. There was a student who was a dancer, and she was homeless and living in a car. None of us had any idea about her situation because she showed up every day for classes and then stayed late in the afternoon to continue dancing. And she was full of life, and she thrived. We rarely know all their stories, but thankfully the arts have given them voice. I'm so proud of my daughter for orchestrating this benefit tonight and choosing to give back to the community who helped raise her, especially in these most unusual of circumstances. These young performers have been empowered, and with your help, many more will have the opportunity to explore and express themselves regardless of their stories. So please, join us in supporting the arts in public education. We hope your hearts have been lifted and your spirits as well.
This extraordinary virtual concert event was made possible this evening by the generous donations from our GoFundMe campaign, from Nicole and Pete Lowry, from Michael Brown, and Linda Proano. Thank you so much for your generosity. Additionally, because of these donations, we are able to give out 4 scholarships this year to 4 extraordinary graduating seniors. I think of my grandmother as the strongest and first musical influence in my life. She was the one who really laid the foundation and solidified my love and appreciation for music and performance. So last year I decided to create a scholarship in her name. This year it is an honor and a privilege to be able to present this scholarship to 4 young women who I have had the privilege of getting to know over the past 3 years. The Marquita King Bean Scholarship for 2020 is awarded to Morgan Reese Page, Maura Sabarats, JoJo Scott, and Josephine McGee. I love you guys. I am exceedingly proud of you. Go out there and give them hell. The link to donate lives below in the description. It's also pinned over there in the comment thread. Please give whatever you can to help us keep the performing arts alive in our public schools. Thank you. I love you.
Hi, everybody. I have the composer, the lyricist of the song in the room with us. This is Benj Pasek. He wrote the lyrics to Dear Evan Hansen and Greatest Showman and La La Land and Giant Peach and Dogfight, and I could go on.
I'm really honored to be here, and I'm really excited about what you guys are doing. And I guess I'll speak a little bit about the song, which is all of these people who are all in their little boxes, just like we are, on their computers, who are alone in their room and who are needing to be reminded that even in times of despair and uncertainty and fear and loneliness, that there are people that love you and there are people that will be there for you. And that if you look to your left and you look to your right and you have the courage to admit when you're in that kind of pit of despair or that sense of loneliness, if you have the courage to admit that you're in that place and reach out, there's going to be somebody who's going to meet you halfway. So I'm really excited to share the song with you guys, have you guys interpret it and end the concert with it in a way that I think feels really, really, really pure to the show, but also pure to this moment that we're all sharing in. And I'm really honored that you guys are going to do it in the concert. So thank you.
All right. I love you. Good night, kiddos.
Have you ever felt like nobody was there? Have you ever felt forgotten in the middle of nowhere? Have you ever felt like you could disappear? Like you could fall and no one would hear? Well, let that lonely feeling wash away. 'Cause maybe there's a reason to believe you'll be okay. 'Cause when you don't feel strong enough to stand, you can reach out your hand. And oh, someone will come running. And I know they'll take you home. Even when the dark comes crashing through, when you need a friend to carry you, when you're broken on the ground, you will be found. So let the sun come streaming in, you'll reach up and your eyes again. Lift your head and look around, you will be found. You will be found. You will be found. You will be found. You will be found.
I've struggled with not feeling good enough.
What have I learned about myself?
Arts have given me a voice.
A sense of purpose.
The freedom of expression.
I have a power.
A safe space.
It gives students a home.
A home.
A home.
Long-lasting friendships.
So many friends.
People in the arts become my family.
A family?
Community.
A huge community.
And I finally felt like it was worth something.
There's a place where we don't have to feel unknown. Every time that you call out, you're a little less alone. If you're lonely, say the word. Oh, from across the silence, your voice is heard. And oh, someone will come running. And I know they'll take you. Even when the dark comes crashing through.